Hi, I am right now in the state of mind of having been totally blown away by a book. I'm in my literary happy place. I often read books I like, but it's less frequent to read a book that feels as original and as brilliant and as compelling as The Hours by Michael Cunningham. So let me back up and tell you how I got to this blissful place. I'm teaching a new series of virtual classes that I call Women's Words. This series starts with a lecture I give about feminist literary highlights, going all the way back to our earliest women novelists and through to the present. And I followed that with a series of book discussions on what I think are some key feminist books. So we started with The Awakening by Kate Chopin, which is a remarkably powerful short novel published in 1899 about a woman who awakens to her own sexuality and the consequences of that. We had a great discussion about it. I was thrilled that a few people in the class were coming to this book for the first time, that I was able to introduce them to it. I've read this book several times, and it never diminishes in its impact, even 120 years after it was published. After that, we did The House of Mirth by Edith Wharton, which is also a favorite of mine. I told my students, and I wasn't really joking, that every time I start this book, I really hope it's going to end differently. But it never does. But if you haven't read a lot of Wharton, I highly recommend her. Start with The House of Mirth or The Age of Innocence. The final book in my series of classes was Mrs. Dalloway by Virginia Woolf, which is a book that you can read over and over and always get something new out of it. And we had a fabulous discussion, which I followed up by choosing to read for myself The Hours by Michael Cunningham. The Hours won a Pulitzer Prize in 1999. I had never read it. It's based on Mrs. Dalloway and on the life of Virginia Woolf. And I just finished it, which brings me back to where I started, which is this totally blown away situation by the extent to which Michael Cunningham seems to have internalized Virginia Woolf's work to a point where he's been true to it, but he has always also made it his own. He uses lines from Mrs. Dalloway, characters from Mrs. Dalloway, but he reworks them into his own story. He makes Virginia Woolf a character in the story. He takes three different time periods with three different stories, weaves them all together. Each one is totally true to all of the themes in Mrs. Dalloway. It's about death and finding meaning in life. There's a lot of water imagery. It's so true to its source, and yet it's entirely original. I read an interesting article recently from The New Yorker by Evan Kindley about how Mrs. Dalloway is proving to be a popular book during the pandemic and how people are rewriting its famous first line, Mrs. Dalloway decided she would buy the flowers herself, into things like Mrs. Dalloway decided she would make the masks herself. We also learn early in the book that Mrs. Dalloway has been ill with influenza. So it's likely that she survived the pandemic of 1918. So, in a lot of ways, it seems to be a great pandemic read. Whether you've read it or not, I encourage you to pick it up now. I encourage you to follow it up with Michael Cunningham, The Hours, and I hope that you too will be blown away by that magnificent book.